Hello and welcome to the third chapter of the STM32WBA5 MOOC. The purpose of this new video is to check together how to modify an existing code example to create a basic Bluetooth low energy peripheral in 10 minutes just by modifying some parameters. For this, we will require you to install STM32 Cube IDE version 1.14, minimum version. As well, in terms of Cube package, STM32 Cube WBA firmware package, we will request you to install 1.3 minimum version. Then, nice to have is a UART terminal. It can be TeraTerm or Hyper Terminal you may have on your laptop. On smartphone side, to connect to our code example running on Nucleo board, we will require you to install the STBLE Toolbox smartphone application, which is available directly on Apple Store or Play Store on iOS and Android. In terms of hardware prerequisites, all this session will be executed on Nucleo WBA55. And this Nucleo WBA55 will be used in all our practical sessions. You will also require to connect your board a USB Type-C cable, Type-C Type-A. The idea is to be able to connect the Nucleo board directly to your laptop. Let's now move to the practical part and start with this basic peripheral in 10 minutes. Click and go. Now, I think you are all set. We all have prerequisite installed on our laptop and we all have the material. So it's time to start. So as a first exercise here, we will use the BLE peer-to-peer server code example, which is an existing code example. We will import it and modify this code example to customize the advertising data. Here, we will change the local name. Then, in the second part of the hands-on, we will generate associated code, flash and test over Nucleo board. What is first peer-to-peer server? Peer-to-peer server is a GAT profile based on Bluetooth Low Energy. This is a proprietary profile, so it uses a ST proprietary unique ID, 128-bit length, and we will see in the next chapter why this unique ID with 128 bits. But basically, the peer-to-peer server will run on Nucleo board and will communicate with a peer-to-peer client running on smartphone. So our smartphone will be the GAT client and GAT central, whereas our Nucleo board will be the GAT server running GAT peripheral. And in this example, we will establish connection, Bluetooth low energy connection between the two devices. And when we will press a button on the Nucleo board, it will send a notification to the GAT client, so to our smartphone. And from our GAT client, we will be able to write into characteristics to control some LED and toggle the LED on GAT server side. So to start with, we will use STM32 Cube ecosystem. The STM32 Cube ecosystem, STM32 CubeMX or CubeIDE, and CubeMX is integrated into CubeIDE, allow to start from three different levels. We can start at example level, board level. Board level can be Nucleo WBA55 board. That means that all the hardware is already configured according to the Nucleo board configuration, or we can also start at chipset level. That means that, for example, if you are designing your own PCB, you will start at chipset level. But coming back to this first click and go, we will start with option number one, which is starting from example application. In this case, it's a complete application running over Nucleo board, here BLE peer-to-peer server. How it works to connect a Nucleo board to your PC? First, we have this Nucleo, which consists of a mezzanine board plus a daughter board. the daughter board is having the WBA55 on it, with antenna and all discrete needed to run it, to be executed. On the mezzanine board, we have some LEDs and button. We have three user buttons here, B1, B2, B3, a reset button, but also some LED that we will use for this session. If you look on the other side of your board, you will see another chipset, which is a ST-Link. This is our debug and flash probe. We will use it to flash, debug, but also as an interface, USB to UART interface to output some logs, for example. So let's start now with BLE peer-to-peer server. So we will open the BLE peer-to-peer server. To do this, we will first open STM32 Cube IDE and select the BLE peer-to-peer server. So for this, I will open STM32 Cube IDE on my laptop. So while opening STM32 Cube IDE, you should obtain such screen, empty screen, and I will select create a new STM32 project. I click on select, and here it will initialize this database and you should obtain this screen. As mentioned previously, this is equivalent to STM32 Cube MX tool. Here you can select to start a project from chipset level, and this is, will be the purpose of hands-on 1 and hands-on 2 session that will come on the next video. Or we can start from a board. If we start from a board, we are talking here about Nucleo board. That means that it will initialize all the hardware for this board. Or we can start from an example. And for this session, we will start from an example and we will start from the BLE peer-to-peer server. So on the name here, we will simply type BLE underscore peer-to-peer server. And then the tool filter a list of code examples matching this name. As you can see, there is many occurrence of the peer-to-peer server because this code example, like many of our ST microelectronics code example, are available on multiple platforms. So we will select the one for Nucleo WBA55. So take care to not click on the blue link. If you click on the blue link, you will access to the whole documentation of the Nucleo board. Whereas we will simply select the line and click on next. By default, it asks to create the project into your default workspace. This is what we will select here. And at this stage, STM32 Cube IDE will generate the code for us. So the first time you execute this, it can take some few minutes. And I just click on finish. And now, if I look on the Project Explorer on the left, I can see my full project is already here. Now, the purpose of this hands-on, on this click and go session, is to modify the advertising data, and this will be the purpose now. For this, I will double click on the .ioc file. Let's double click on .ioc file, and here, .ioc file is a project, is a Cube IDE project, Cube MX project, with the definition of all the pinout, project, component, and so on, peripheral use in the project. And when you open it, you should get this screen. Okay, so when the .ioc is fully open, we get access to this new panel, which allows to configure everything in our project example. So this panel is divided in three parts. On the right side, you have a graphical view of the pinout of the chip. Here you can see in red purple the different GPIOs that are used for LED and button.
as well. You have the connection for the UART, for the external low speed and high speed crystal. Then on the left side of the screen, we get access to all components, all software and hardware components used in this project. That means that we can see that we use some RAM, we use the RCC peripherals, timers, but as well some software components like the STM32WPAN. And this one is related to the Bluetooth low energy and the RF in general. In our case, it is Bluetooth low energy. So here, everything is configured already according to the BLE peer-to-peer server code example. And the idea here is now to modify the advertising data and especially local name. For this, we will go to the BLE advertising tab. So one more time, select component STM32WPAN, go to BLE advertising and check for local name. And we will modify this local name. I will call it here WBA MOOC. Of course, here you are free to put what you want as a name. The only limitation is the maximum length of advertising data. Here, the maximum length allowed for this name is up to 10 bytes. If you go higher than 10 bytes, there is not enough space and have free space in the advertising data lens. That is one limitation here, linked to the BLE specification. Then we modify the local name, but we will also modify the device name. Why do we need to modify the device name here? This is because of iOS management. On iOS, display local name, so the local name is part of the advertising data, but prior to the first connection, once we establish a first connection using iOS device, iOS will associate the MAC address to the device name, and then after it will display only the device name. So the idea is to use the device name equal to local name. This is a standard way to manage. Of course, you can manage as you want, but we advise to use device name equal to local name. And this is what we will do now. So I will enter the same here, WBA MOOC. So here I put WBA MOOC as device name and local name. So now I'm done, so I can ask to generate the code with this new device name and new local name. So I will simply click on this wheel here to generate the code, and it will ask me to change perspective to go to the C++ perspective. Code is now under generation. The first time you generate code, it may take a few minutes. It can take up to 1 minute. Afterwards, if you simply change one setting, it can go very fast. Okay, code is now open. I can open here the code. I can check if the code is well generated. If I open STM32WPAN, I expand this folder, going to app, double click on appble.c. Scrolling a bit, I can see that the device name and the local name, the advertising data field, was changed with the name I set in the graphical interface. So I can now build the project and flash the project. To build the project, I will simply click on this hammer icon here. So just click on build. And let's see if the build is okay. You have access to the console and the potential issue during the build that is available here on the bottom left corner. So waiting for the end of this build, I will then connect my Nucleo board to my laptop to be able to flash it. So build is now over, zero warning, so fine, good. I can now flash and run my code example. For this, I will click on this icon here. This is the run icon. And the first time, he say, okay, I don't know what to launch. I will simply click on run configuration. So here, close to this green arrow, there is a scroll button run configuration. I will select C, STM32C, C++ application, double click, and I will select my .elf, peer-to-peer server .elf, and click on run. Here, STM32CubeIDE, thanks to the onboard ST-Link, will be able to flash and download my board. And now, this is done. I can start now playing with my peer-to-peer server. Let's now see what's happening on Nucleo WBA55 board. My Nucleo WBA55 is now fully flashed with the BLE peer-to-peer server firmware. I can see even a green LED blinking here, which indicates device is advertising. That means that I can use my smartphone to connect to it. My device is advertising with advertising data, saying, hello, I'm here, and my name is local name I define. So on smartphone side, I will use the STBLE toolbox application that will start automatically to scan for all Bluetooth low energy devices around. All device advertising, and one of these devices which is advertising is my device WBA MOOC. This is the local name I defined just previously. So I can connect to it. Once connected, I can see three services, two generic services that you may not see on iPhone, on iOS, because they are automatically filtered. But we have this proprietary service, peer-to-peer server, which is the one we are looking for today. So let me click on this peer-to-peer server. And here I can see LED icon I can use to toggle the LED on my Nucleo board. You see, if I toggle the LED on smartphone, the blue LED is toggling on my Nucleo board. That means that I can control the LED from my smartphone. On the opposite way, if I push the B1 button, I receive an information, a notification about button press. I can do it second time. So that means here, I'm able to control a LED on the Nucleo board, and I'm able to receive notification from my Nucleo board. That means that I'm able to discuss with my Nucleo board, my device, in both directions. A last point on this section I would like to share with you is the possibility to have some UART logs using this BLE peer-to-peer code example. But this is valid for all BLE code examples. So for this, I will simply open an Hyper Terminal or TerraTerm, any terminal, UART terminal you may use, and connect to my Nucleo board. My Nucleo board is CON 110 in my side, so I will select it, okay. Then set up the serial port speed to 115 bits per second, validate. And now, for example, if I reset my board, I can see all the log about the main call to the BLE stack. Setting takes power level, gap get init, start advertising, and so on. So this can be very useful for your debug session, and those logs can be activated very simply. Well done! We have been able together to customize an existing code example to make it fit our needs. To illustrate this, we customized the advertising data and we have been able to rebuild this code example and make it working on our board. Now we use Nucleo board.
And the next session that my colleague Dominique will present to you is this time to start from scratch. We will start from the chipset level and build our full application. So let me now let the floor to my colleagues Dominique that will present you this next session. Thank you for your attention and stay tuned.